Calling all stations, calling all stations, calling all stations to be Sierra's net. This is K9JAJ, Kilo 9 Juliet Alpha Juliet. Net control for this session of the BC Aries Net. Are there any stations holding emergency, priority, or welfare traffic? If so, please call net control at this time. Any station needing to pass emergency traffic at any time during the net, please alert net control with the pro words break break, and I will assist you with that emergency. Once again, your net control is K9JJ. My name is Jeff, and I'm located here in Columbus in Bartholomew County. This net is held every Wednesday evening at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time as an Aries training session and proper net procedures and to provide information regarding Aries and other ham radio-related activity in Bartholomew and surrounding counties. All stations are welcome to check in. You do not need to bring traffic to the net, nor do you need to be a BC Aries team member. This is, however, a directed net, so please direct all communications through net control at all times. At this time, any stations holding non-emergency or routine traffic, please call now. With there being no traffic listed and no announcements for the net, I will now begin taking check-ins. Check-ins are handled alphabetically according to call sign suffix. Please check in by stating your call sign using plain English and then standard ITU phonetics followed by your name and your county. At this time, stations with suffixes Alpha through Lima. That's Alpha through Lima only. Please call net control K9JAJ.
Charlie Juliet Tango, Noel in Bartholomew County.
KD 9 Romeo Papa Bravo, Bruce in Bartholomew County.
9 RBP, good evening, Bruce. Additional stations with call sign suffixes Alpha through Lima, please call. Zulu, Mike through Zulu, please call.
Kilo 9, Romeo, Mike, Romeo, repeat, K9RMR, Randall M. Ruth, Taylorsville, Bartholomew County. Good evening to everybody on the net.
W9, MDT, Whiskey 9, Mike, Delta Tango, Mike, Columbus, Bartholomew County.
K9OPL, Kilo Alpha 9, Oscar Papa Lima, Joe, Bartholomew County.
Acknowledging K9RMR, W9MDT, and KA9OPL. Was there another station in there? We had some doubling going on. Please call again, please. No, perhaps that was one of the last three. This is K9JAJ with BC Aries Net. We're taking check-ins. We're taking check-ins from any station anywhere, Alpha through Zulu. Please call.
N9JFH, November 9, Juliet, Foxtrot Hotel, Paul.
N9JFH, good evening, Paul, out there in Decatur County. Anyone else, please call.
Kilo Delta 9, Sierra Bravo, KD9SB, Gary, Bartholomew County.
Good evening, Gary, KD9SB. Anyone else? Have it so far with N9CJT for comments. Good evening, Noel. Your comments, please.
Oh, good evening, Jeff. I spent a good chunk of the day today catching up on my snow shoveling. And I guess I'll catch up again next week. Hi, hi. That's all I've got. N9CJT back to net control.
K9CJT, K9JJ, okay, Noel, well, if you're looking for more shoveling to do, I'm sure we could find you some. Thanks for checking in. I guess you, your Wednesday evening study was postponed again.
Actually, it's set aside for the season of Lent, and then we'll pick it back up afterwards. Technically, I'm supposed to be at a church service right now, but didn't get the shoveling done until too late. N9CJT, back to net.
Okay, well, we'll look forward to having you on the net for the next several weeks then. Yes, today is Ash Wednesday for those that have that as part of their worship. We'll break with Noel. Thanks for being here, and we'll check in with KD9RBP. Good evening, Bruce. Welcome to the net once again. Your comments, please.
Yeah, that's KD9RPB. I'm not much different than Noel. Just finished up some of the snow shoveling that I did yesterday and didn't quite get it all because I had a vehicle in the way. So other than that, just staying indoors. Back to net control.
KD9RPB, Romeo Papa, Bravo. Okay, thank you for that correction, Bruce. Sorry about that. Bruce, you're scheduled to for VE testing next Tuesday since we canceled. Is that correct?
Yeah, that is correct. I figured that just gives me a little bit more time to brush up on my math skills.
Yeah, well, that's a good way of looking at it. I was listening to you and Noel talk the other night when he loaded some traffic off on you, and he mentioned some pink and yellow cards that I might have, and I do have those cards, and I will do my darn best to remember to bring them and give them off to you next Tuesday. So we'll look forward to seeing you then. We'll break with Bruce and check in with Taylorsville K9RMR. Good evening, Randall.
Well, good evening, Jeff, and everybody in the net. It's cold and white here in Taylorsville, Indiana as well. According to the internet, we're supposed to be getting 1 to 2 inches before tomorrow morning. So whether we do or not, who knows, but that's what they're saying. So, I'm like Noel, aside from the snow, not a whole lot going on. So with that, I'll turn it back to net control.
Tonight, likely mainly after 3 a.m., so we'll see what the morning ride to work looks like, but I don't suspect it's going to amount to a whole lot. Certainly not as much as we had the other day. But you take care, stay warm out there, and thanks for checking in. Break with you and check in with Mike, W9MDT. Good evening, Mike. Any comments or information to pass along for the net this evening?
J.A.J., this is W9MDT. I was going to tell Bruce this week that I have a few of those cards as well when we were going through the message handling training, and but if you're gonna bring some, I'll just hang on to mine. but I have done very little today. We going through stuff, and I just can't believe we have so much junk. In this house that we have to make a decision on, either throw it away, give it away, or take it to Goodwill. And every day, and every time it's like, oh wow, I didn't know we had that, or I forgot about that. We've got the house in Greene County. I went over Monday, and I didn't chance going down the hill to the house in the truck. And I parked on the road and walked down. It was pretty deep. The snow was, and I don't know. I don't have anything to remove that snow yet. That's really about it for me. I mentioned last night. right, that I did some RTTY over the weekend, and that was kind of fun. I also yesterday was just kind of surfing through the digital section of the bands, and I came across a guy calling CQ on Olivia 8500, and so I had a chat with him. We talked for probably close to a half hour, and that was really interesting. Gentleman up in Canada, that's about all the exciting news that I've got. If you got QST magazine this, I got mine today, and I was looking at it, and the guy on the cover, I'm like, who is that? That guy looks familiar to me. And I read some more, and it was the guy from up in, I think, Noblesville area that helped coordinate the Tandem event a couple of years ago, and so that was good to see him on there. But anyway, with that, Jeff, I'll turn it back to you. I haven't gotten any shoveling done. I shoveled down to the drive, and then the city, or down to the road, and then the city come by and put a great big old pile in my driveway. So I'm not going to worry about it. I'll let Mother Nature take care of it next week. But with that, Jeff, I'll turn it back to you. K9JAJ, this is W9MDT, back to net control.
Okay, Mike. Yeah, we have that same kind of issue over here. Every winter we say the same thing. We're better off if the city would just not bother plowing our cul-de-sac, because there's four houses back here, and they just they make it worse and more difficult for us to get in and out of our driveways, for the mail person to get up to our mailboxes, for us to get to our mailboxes, and they push all that snow right up into the yard, and sometimes the bottom of the plow comes right in and digs up the yard and stuff. It's just not a good thing. We're better off if they just leave us alone, especially when there's only a few inches out there. So, but anyway, hope you get squared away, and I understand accumulating a lot of stuff over the years. We've moved several times, and there was one time, we've lived in Pennsylvania, we moved to Tennessee, Ohio, Nevada, and here, and there was at least one move where when we were packing up, we came across a box that was labeled and tagged from the previous move, and we never got around to opening it. But ever since then, my wife's had a very strict rule. If something hasn't been opened for more than 6 months, we don't need it, so get rid of it. But anyway, thanks for stopping by, and hopefully we'll see you this coming Tuesday, if not sooner. We'll break with Mike and check in with Joe, KA9OPO. Good evening, Joe. Your comments for the net.
Good evening, Jeff and Nat, K9OPL. I'm on my handheld, so hopefully this holds up. Not a lot to report. Went out with a friend to do a little grocery shopping before, and we just got back a little while ago, and that was fine. At least our driveway's got an open spot enough in it to go out there. And just normal work week otherwise, staying inside. Turn it back to you, Jeff. This is KA9OPL, back to net.
K9OPL, K9JJ. Okay, Joe, yeah, your handy talk is working just fine. Nice, solid signal. Full quieting here. But, glad you got to get out and got back okay. and we'll hopefully see you on Tuesday as well. Thanks for being here, buddy. Next up, Manhunt, Decatur County, N9JFH. Good evening, Paul. How are things your way?
21 degrees and dropping, probably. Not too bad. I got an old toy out. I used to live in Pennsylvania, too, and I bought a snowblower when I lived there, and then we moved from there to Kentucky and hardly ever got snow down there, but I did use it maybe once or twice in 8 years, but I realized, man, it's been 8 years since I've even had that thing out, and for 1 or 2 inches, it's hardly worth it. But I got it out, but it took a while to get started. After I got it started, it ran fairly good, but it definitely needs a tune-up somewhere. I went down then and to south of Vernon and used it at my daughter's place, and then came up to my son's in North Vernon and hit a aluminum rod that he had in the backyard, that a back driveway that he'd forgot he had sitting there, and boy, it locked the auger right up, but it sheared the bolt. So I was in Columbus today buying some new aluminum shear bolts, try to replace that, get that thing fixed, at least rather that go than something else internally. But other than that, just cleaning up the snow around our place and family, that's about all I've got done in the last 2 days. Others have been talking about moving. As a pastor, I've moved here and yon, so I know what that's all about too. Been there, done that. So I'm tired of it. I hope we stay here for a while. Nothing else here in Westport. This is N9JFH. I'll return it back to net control.
Okay, Paul. Yeah, moving around is a lot of fun. Hi. But I've been trying to get my snowblower working for about a week now. I didn't even bother messing with it tonight. But I was out there probably the last 3 or 4 days in a row spraying it with the starter fluid and doing this and that, and I still can't get that darn thing to fire up. So I don't know what's going on there. I'm about ready to just do what Mike said, let Mother Nature take care of it. Something about it being up around 41 come Sunday, so we'll see what happens. But anyhow, appreciate you being here, and you take care out there. I'm sure your kids appreciated you stopping by and taking care of that stuff for them. We'll say good evening to Paul and check in with Gary, KD9SB, at the bottom of the list. Good evening, Gary. How are things out your way?
Good evening, Nat. They're doing we're in pretty good shape out here. We're not doing too much. I want to wish those that are going to be taking the FCC exams good luck. You've got a good time to extra time maybe to prepare this shot if you're not working and you got plenty of time. And I'm sure that all the workers and such of the examining committee would be backing that. And I just want to wish those people good luck, because I remember how exciting that is when you take the FCC exams. Anyway, that's about it. This is KD9SB.
Okay, roger that, Gary. Yeah, I remember back in 71 when I took my first novice test at the middle school I was going to at the time. We had a radio club, and Mr. Thomas was my science teacher, and he was a ham and taught us the 5 words a minute code and all that good stuff. Passing that and then passing the written part, it was an exciting time, and really appreciate him getting me into the hobby as he did. Let's see what else. Not much going on here at the JAJQTH. We had a bit of a plumbing problem the other day. Came downstairs early in the morning with with my cup of coffee, went back upstairs to get something, and I slipped and fell right on my keister on the hardwood floor upstairs. Couldn't understand why the bottom of my shoes were wet. After I peeled myself up off the floor and obtained what I went back upstairs to get, I came back downstairs. This time I put the light on and noticed several wet spots in the rug down here. And then I looked inside the laundry room and noticed the inch or more water on the floor there. Well, it seeped under the wall and into the radio room on the floor. So we've been trying to dry the place out. We had to get a plumber out here to clear the sewer line. Apparently it was frozen up a little bit. Needed some attention, but could have been a lot worse. And we're grateful that it wasn't. Missed a little bit of work the other day due to the weather. We didn't open up until 12:30. I guess that was yesterday. And town was under the warning, so cars were off the road to give the snow plow crews plenty of time to do what they had to do. We appreciate all the effort they put into it. But that's about all I've got this week. At this time, we'll take a short standby, see if we have anyone else wishing to check in. This is K9JAJ. This is the BC Aries Net, Bartholomew County Amateur Radio Emergency Service Net. Here every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. on the Columbus Amateur Radio Club 2-meter repeater. If you're listening and you'd like to check in, please do so now. Well, looks like that's it, fellas. Does anyone have any additional comments, queries, or otherwise? If so, please call.
N9CJT.
Go ahead, Noel.
Well, I noticed Mike talking about accumulating lots of stuff. I just wanted to make a quick plug for a local charity. There's a group called Hands and Feet Ministry. It's backed up by four different churches here in the community and several private individuals as well. And its purpose is to provide furniture, kitchenware, bedding, that sort of thing, to ladies that are being placed out of Turning Point shelter, domestic violence shelter. And there's a place where donations in the way of furniture, etc., can be stored. So if you have any questions as to what they want or who to contact, just contact me when you decide to do so, and I'll be glad to give some more information. N9CJT back to net control. Thanks, Jeff.
Okay, Noel, appreciate that public service announcement. Mike, do you have any questions regarding that for Noel?
Not at this time, but thank you very much for the information. That gives us another avenue anyway. Back to you, Jeff. K9JJ, W9MDT, back to net control.
All righty then. Anyone else have anything before we shut her down? All right, well, with there being nothing further for the net, I do want to thank each and every one of you who checked into the net this evening, and as always, special thanks to the Columbus Amateur Radio Club for allowing us to have the net on their repeater every week. We sure do appreciate that, and at this time, I will now return that repeater to regular amateur radio use. The time here is 7:56 p.m. Eastern Time. That's 0056 Zulu. The net is now closed, and K9JJ will say 73, and I'm clear.